Welcome to this edition of Sporting School. On this edition, we get to take you to Butabika via Jens Cambridge International School for the 2018 Junior NBA, where Setnoa Girls, Kisasi College Girls, Budo Girls, Watoto Girls, Saku Hornets, Bethel Nets, Watoto Boys, Aga Khan High School, Taiwa High, Budo SS, and Crane High School all took part for a place in the finals. We also get to meet our star of the week, all the way from South Sudan. And on our sports autos, we get to finalize it with Arsenal legend Thierry Henry in his autobiography book, where he gets to say his goodbyes to the Arsenal faithful before he left for Barcelona. On our quote of the week, step out of the history that is holding you back. Step into the new story you are willing to create, he added. When you innovate, you've got to be prepared for people telling you you are nuts. Our greatest weakness lies in giving up. The most certain way to succeed is always to try just one more time. If you can't fly, then run. If you can't run, then walk. If you can't walk, then crawl. But whatever you do, you have to keep moving forward. Welcome to yet another edition of Sporting School. What we have here today is the Junior NBA down here in Butabika via James Cambridge International School, where over 12 schools will be in contention for a place in the finals of this year's Junior NBA. All this coming up on Sporting School. The Junior NBA Football League provides boys and girls ages from 12 to 15 and their coaches throughout 30 schools with the opportunity to learn and develop their basketball skills through a competitive league. The Junior NBA Football League features 30 teams from 30 schools across Kampala. The schools will be divided into Eastern and Western conferences, with the top 8 teams in each conference qualifying for the playoffs at the end of the season, with single elimination playoffs and final to determine the Junior NBA Football League champion. Each of the schools will represent one of the 30 NBA teams and will receive corresponding NBA team branded attire for their games, web which will span 8 weeks from June through August. The league is aimed at promoting core values such as teamwork, discipline, leadership, fitness, and healthy living through the games and competition. The boys and girls will be able to get the right basics at a young age. The NBA and FUBA are great to have boys and girls playing in the month of June to the month of August to develop their skills in the long run. FUBA cited a challenge of having the schools honoring the fixtures and traveling to the other schools, and the schools came out to promise that they will be able to play in as many games as possible. The NBA hopes to grow the sport of basketball and bring it at a level where fans are able to appreciate the sport in basketball. The day started off with the girls, where Setnoa went on to lock horns with Kisasi College girls, who fell out horribly to Setnoa 21-45 as they hit the exit, with Setnoa progressing into the next round. Next up was Watoto girls, who were humiliated by Budo SS girls 37-16, with the 11-year-old youngster in Maya Belinda pulling off some fine moves during the game despite being on the losing side.
Tell us, what inspires you to play basketball?
My sister.
Your sister?
Yes.
You just lost out to a very strong side in Budo. How disappointed are you?
Very disappointed.
You look to be very effective amongst your teammates. Are you satisfied with the way you performed today as an individual?
Yes.
Okay, can you take us through some of the things that you could have corrected during the game?
I beg your pardon?
Could you take us through some of those things, some of those elements you could have corrected during the game?
Defense.
What about defense? What about it?
I had to defend my man.
Okay, and you felt like you weren't very defensive enough?
Yes.
All right, any lessons learned from today's encounter? Anything you can walk away with today?
Yes.
Like?
I've learned to pass the ball.
Learn how to pass the ball?
Yes.
You feel disadvantaged by your height and your strength?
No.
No? You think you can take on the big girls during your time of play?
Yes.
Lukwago Jasmine with Watoto Girls team runners through her experience of featuring in the Junior NBA League as she looks forward to yet another thrilling season.
We are going to play our semifinals.
What has it been like playing in the junior NBA?
Pardon, please.
What has it been like playing in the junior NBA?
We pass the ball, and when you pass the ball, you have to go some behind, and when the person is this on the right hand, the person who's outside has to be on the left side.
Tell me about your experience since you joined the team, with the Watoto team. Tell me about experience. What has it been like for you? Has it been a good experience or bad experience? Any challenges?
Good experience.
Good experience.
Yes.
Anything that you've managed to pick up since you joined the team?
Yes.
Like?
Handling the ball, passing the ball, dribbling while looking up.
How has sport helped you to improve your life as an individual?
It has helped me to change on my studies.
Your studies?
Yes.
Besides studies, what else do you do besides being in school?
Sometimes I play football.
Sometimes you play football?
Yes.
All right, tell me before I let you go, what are your expectations today with the Watoto team?
I'm going to make sure I dribble while looking up, I pass the ball, and I be strong while playing.
The tie was followed by Bethel High School up against Sako SS, who started well in the first quarter but later on gave it in to Bethel High School, who had three gigantic teens from South Sudan who changed the game for Bethel to win it 43-28 to reach the next round. Adeng Kering, a student with Bethel High School, was outstanding and his contribution was massive as he came from the bench to win it for Bethel High School against a relatively strong side in Sako SS.
Yeah, by the way, that's how we can play. Yeah, and you have to fight for your own to make your school to be the best and make sure that you have to win the champion to be the best.
You seem to have the height advantage. Obviously, I'm shorter than you are, but you think there was an advantage going into that encounter?
Yeah, we have advantage of height because those guys are short and we are tall, and we have like three tall guys. That's what we do, and we win the game because we have a height. That's why we did it.
Looking at the collective effort today, you as an individual, are you satisfied with the way you played as a collective?
As for me, I can't say that I play well today because me, I miss a lot of basketball, and it is good for me to apply the ball, but I miss a chance to do that. Yeah,
but look. Looking at what the coach had, instructed you guys to do, especially in the third quarter, did you feel like he wasn't too happy?
Yeah, I wasn't happy because I was missing a lot of basketball, and that's why I was just outside. It is good sometimes if you're missing a lot of basketball, you have to be like to give in a sub and to rest some time. That's why he just saw me before I was tired. That's why he called me outside to come and rest some time, and I got back inside again.
What are your expectations? What are your expectations? Your next game?
The next game, I'm trying to say that, girl, we have to go hard because we are not, now the game that we play, we are not playing it well as we play it. This is not our game. We didn't play it well today, as we see today. This is not our game. What I can just say, next game, just be focused to go hard because you're going for semis. What the name? Final conference. You have to go hard.
Jeremiah Mugagai, player with Watoto Boys, came out to share his excitement with us as he was looking forward to win against Aga Khan High School, who had a late arrival from their head coach.
The female team just lost out to a very strong side. Do you feel like you, as an individual, that could be a setback going into your next game?
I will play hard for the girls because they have beat them, but our game, I will make that lose go away.
You seem to be very excited about this event today. Anything in particular you're looking forward to?
Beating Aga Khan today. Yeah.
What has preparation been like for you?
Preparation? Good, but not very good.
When you look at basketball, is this something you can do in the future as a profession?
Yeah.
Any reason as to why?
Reason as to why? Because I like basketball and I'm looking forward to play basketball in my future.
Expectations today, a win today?
A win.
Anything to back that up? You have good teammates in there?
Yes. Okay. Like, my good teammate is Elijah Junior, and my point guard is Kevin and Rihanna.
You look very nervous. Is that something that we should be worried about?
Yes.
Watoto boys were just too strong for Gakan High School, who were not that accurate in front of the hoop as they trailed throughout the four quarters, losing to Watoto 26-32, with their better game coming through in the third and fourth quarter a little bit too late to save the game.
Well, it was a good game, but what can I say? It's always tough to lose now, but we'll be ready for the next season.
Positives from this encounter for you as a player?
Well, I've got some experience with the big guys. This is my first junior NBA season, so I've learned a lot from how to play and the coaches. So, yeah.
Ali Omar, your contribution was felt, especially in the third and fourth quarter. Can you run us through that? What exactly did the coach tell you?
The coach just wanted us to attack quickly, and that's what I tried to do, but unfortunately, we came up short.
Ali, so do you feel disappointed by the fact that the coach didn't give you so much playing time today?
No, I was okay with the time I played with, so I'm happy with what I did.
Ali, before we let you guys go, what next after this defeat? Any lessons learned?
Yeah, we need to. In this game, I believe we lost it because we started slow. So from after here, I know that every game you need to start with intensity and finish the same one.
In the other games played out, Crane High beat hosts in James Cambridge International School 51-45 in overtime, while Budo SS fell out to Taipei International School 43-45 in a highly contested affair. We wrapped it up with a teenager in Joshua Anis from St. Peter's Nadia, who happens to like the game of basketball just for the sake of it.
You seem to have interest in the sport of basketball. What pushes you to play this sport? What excites you about this sport?
I just like it.
You just like it?
Yeah.
Any reason behind that like?
No.
No reason in particular?
No.
Today you're here for the junior NBA. What are your expectations?
Nothing.
You have no expectations?
No.
That is quite interesting. How do you intend to help your team to win today?
I'll have to play well.
You'll have to play well?
Yeah.
Tell me, how do you prepare yourself for such events?
You have to go for training.
How often do you train? In a week? Twice, three times a week?
Four times a week? Yeah.
And how do you balance school and training?
I go for training in the evening and at daytime I'm at school.
Okay. Any last words you'd like to share with us before we let you go?
Not really.
Not really?
Yeah.
Would you like to send some greetings?
Yeah.
To?
To everyone watching. My name is Joshua. I'm in St. Peter's Nalia. You are watching Sports in School.
After the break, we get to meet our star of the week and get to continue with the Arsenal legend in Thierry Henry in his final days of the club in Arsenal.